Hi there, this is HackRich. In previous video, we discussed what are the protection against stack buffer overflow and how can we bypass those protection. In this video, let's discuss return to LibC attack. This is the perfect bypass for file protection and NX protection. NX means non-executable stack protection. So let's get started. This is the vulnerable code we are going to use for this exercise. So this is similar to the code which we use for shellcode execution, right? Okay. In order to understand return to LibC attack, you need to know two things. First one is you need to understand how calling convention works for 32-bit program and 64-bit program. So this thing we already discussed in earlier videos. If you haven't watched that video, you can find it through the iCard appearing in the top corner. So second thing is you need to know how to find out the LibC function address which you want to execute. So that thing we will discuss in this video. So whenever we generate the executable file, there will be two kind of linking. One is static linking and another one is dynamic linking. In static linking, whatever the predefined function you have used in your code will be part of your executable file. In dynamic linking, there will be shared library, which will contain the definition of all predefined function. So in static linking, linking will be done in compile time. In dynamic linking, linking will be done in runtime. So this shared library in dynamic linking will contain the definition of all the function. So the function we are interested in is system function, because what does system function do? System function will execute whatever the string we pass to it. So if we pass slash bin slash sh string to system function, it will give us the shell. So what we do, first we will find out the base address of libc, and then we will find out the offset of system function, and then we will find out the offset of slash bin slash sh string. So before that, we will discuss how our payload should look like in theoretically, then we will find out those address and we will build a payload. So this is the stack frame for foo function. So first what we do, we will do the same thing as we did it in earlier videos. First we will find out the length of the padding, then we will override this return address by system function address. So then we will add the return address for system function. So if you don't understand why do we need this return address, go and watch the calling convention for 32-bit program. You can find it in this buffer overflow playlist. So after that, we will add the function parameter for system function, that is slash bin slash sh string. So let's find out the base address of libc and offset of this system function and this slash bin slash sh string. So before doing anything, let's disable the ASLR, because ASLR is the protection for return to libc attack. So in order to find out the base address of libc, we can use ldd command. So ldd command basically tells that what are the shared library linked to particular binary file. So this is the libc file and its base address is this. So in order to find out the offset of system function, so we can use read elf -s tells that search for symbol in this libc file, and we are going to grab only system function. So this is the offset for system function. So in order to find out the offset for slash bin slash sh string, so we can say string minus a. So minus a tell that scan entire file, then minus tx. So minus tx for output offset in hexadecimal, then pass to libc file, then grab slash bin slash stretch. So this is the option. So here I already find out the length of the padding using GDP. If you don't know how to find out that, you can watch the video appearing in the icon. So let's build the payload. First, let's import the pound tool from pound import star. Let's create the process. Process name of the executable file. Let's print out whatever the content received from this payload process. Then padding which is 52 byte long, then first I will find libc base address. This is libc base address. Then system function. System function address will be E32. Libc base address plus offset of system function. Then return address, which is dummy address, then parameter. So address of this string is base address plus this offset. So let's pass this payload to process. Padding plus system function address, then return address, then parameter. Let's print out the content received from the process after passing the payload. Let's call the interactive function to get the interactive shell. Save this. So before running the exploit, let's check what are the protection is enabled for a 132 executable file using check tech tool. File equal one. So non-executable stack protection is enabled and pipe protection is also enabled. So let's run the exploit. Yeah, we got the shell. So this is how we can utilize the return to libc attack to bypass the non-executable stack protection and pipe protection. So let's build the payload for 64-bit program. So this is the payload we have used for 32-bit, right? In 64-bit, calling convention is completely different from 32-bit, because in 32-bit, function parameter will be pushed into stack. In 64-bit, function parameter will be loaded into register. So if you don't know how calling convention works for 64-bit, go and watch the video, calling convention for 64-bit program. You can find that video in this buffer overflow playlist. We need to find out the gadget, so RDI gadget. Then we will load this bin/sh string to RDI register. Then we will call the system function. So payload will be first we will load the /bin/sh string to RDI register. For that, gadget address. Then slash bin slash sh then system function. So this is how payload look like for 64-bit program. So let's find out the address of this RDI gadget, then we will find out the address of base address of libc, then we will find out the offset of system function and slash bin slash sh string. So first let's find out the pop RDI gadget address. You just say pop gadget binary. Yeah, so this is the gadget we are interested in. So this is the address. So let's find out the base address of libc. So this is the base address of libc. This is the path of libc file. So let's find out the offset of system function. Can you use readelf? Yeah. So this is the offset of system function. So then let's find out the offset of slash bin slash sh string. So this is the offset of slash bin slash sh string. So let's build the payload using pound tool. So here I already find out the length of the padding. So let's import the pound tool from pound import star. So let's create the process. Process name of the executable file with 164. So let's print out what are the content received from this executable file p.receive. So let's build the payload. First padding. Padding is 56 byte long. Then pop RDI gadget. The address is this. And then parameter is slash bin slash sh string. So its address is libc base address plus its offset. So before that I have to define the libc base address. Libc base address this. Libc base address plus its offset. Then system function. Libc base address plus its offset. Okay, let's send this payload process. Padding pop RDI param system function. So let's print out what are the content received from the process after sending this payload. So let's call the interactive function to get the interactive shell. Let's save this. So before running that exploit, let's check what are the protection is enabled for 164 binary. Check set file 164. So non-executable stack protection is enabled, but PI is disabled because if I enable the PI, that gadget address, RDI gadget address, will be different every time we run the program. So that's why I disable the PI protection. So now let's run the exploit. Yeah, we got the shell. So that is it for this video. So until then, stay tuned, like the video, and subscribe the channel.